Almost 1 year ago, Flutter Flock was introduced with quite a lot of noise. So naturally, almost 1 year after its announcement, the question is, how is the project doing? What remains of this project? And of course, you might already have an idea where this video is going, but let's start at the basics. At least briefly, I won't bore you though. Flutter, of course, is a pretty popular and successful cross-platform framework that aims to simplify building applications for Android, iOS, desktop, and web. You can use one code base, one programming language, Dart with the Flutter framework to build these applications. That's Flutter. It's successful, people like it. But just as with most bigger projects, there are issues, of course. For example, the Flutter team is not super quick about fixing certain bugs or implementing community feedback. It is under active development, don't get me wrong, but yeah, people can feel like priorities might not always be aligned with what the community wants, and there certainly are examples for issues that maybe should have been fixed by now, but aren't. Still, it is popular, but Flutter Flock, this initiative, this project, which was announced a year ago, aimed to do better. The goal was to fork Flutter, to copy it, so to say, and to stay up to date with Flutter, so to automatically include the changes that are made to Flutter, but on top of that, to make it better, to fix certain long-standing issues, to listen to the community and add features the community wants, which the official Flutter team doesn't seem to add or doesn't seem to want to add. And so on. So a better version of Flutter that is keeping up with the regular development of Flutter. That was the goal. Now, when Flutter Flock was introduced a year ago, it was quite polarizing. There were people that were really excited about the project because they wanted a better Flutter, because it sounded promising, and because, of course, one advantage of this project also would be that the Flutter team could simply take a look at what Flutter Flock is doing, and if certain changes were implemented there and were therefore tested by the community and were doing well, they could merge it back into the main Flutter repo, for example. So it could be almost like a testing ground in addition to being a better version of Flutter for people that want to use it. On the other hand, there also were people that were afraid that this would kind of split the community, that it would lead to fragmentation in the Flutter ecosystem, and that therefore weren't too excited about the project. Now, good news is, for that second group of people, it looks like the project is pretty dead. Yeah. I mean, if you take a look at the official website, as far as I can tell, it has exactly the same state as a year ago. No news, no new blog posts or announcements or anything like that. I wasn't really able to find meaningful communication by the people mentioned on that website that started this initiative. I found a 9-month-old Reddit thread where people already were asking and discussing whether the project is dead, and it doesn't look like things got better since then. And if you simply take a look at the official GitHub repository, which is probably the best indicator, on first sight it might look like there's lots of activity there, but if you take a closer look and compare it to the activity of the official Flutter repository, you quickly see, oh, most of that is just the automatic merging of changes made to Flutter, because remember, the goal was to keep up with the development of Flutter. Now, there are some additional commits, but to be very honest, nothing that gives me the feeling that this is a super active project. Now, of course, it is possible that it will pick up steam again, or for the first time, I guess, it is possible that there were whatever reasons that led to this project not seeing a lot of progress in the last year, but finally the people behind it, or the person behind it, not sure how big the team is going to dedicate more time to that project. But it's also quite possible, and arguably seems more likely right now, that not a lot is going to happen in this project, that it didn't get the traction they wanted, that they're not getting the community contributions they wanted, that it's too much for a single person, and that therefore eventually it might die. Now, I don't know, obviously, what the future will bring. Again, it is possible that things will change, but right now, it doesn't really look like Flutter really got flocked. So yeah, if you weren't too happy about it in the first place, good news for you. Doesn't seem like it's a big danger for Flutter.